Hello and welcome to A Beginner's Guide to RPG in a Box. My name is Sarah, and I'm the wife of Justin Arnold, the creator of RPG in a Box. Maybe you have RPG in a Box and have no idea where to begin. Maybe you're interested in getting RPG in a Box and would like to know more about it. Or maybe you have no idea what RPG in a Box is, how you got here, or why you're still watching this video. If so, you're in the right place. This video will cover what RPG in a Box is, creating a new project in RPG in a Box, navigating the interface, the assets used in RPG in a Box, and a quick overview of the editors for those assets, how those assets combine to create a game, testing your game with quick play, and exporting it to share with others. Now, as this is an introductory video, I won't be showing how to use each editor or covering all the functions RPG in a Box has to offer. I'll instead be covering those topics in detail in their own individual videos in the future. What is RPG in a Box? RPG in a Box is a game engine designed to help you easily create 3D grid-based RPGs and adventure games. It is currently in alpha, and new features are regularly being added. As of the recording of this video, the latest version is 0.6.4. So in the future, if you're using a newer version, your program might look a little different. If you would like to purchase RPG in a Box, it is available on Steam, itch.io, and the Humble Store, and I'll leave links to each of those locations in the description below. There's also a demo version of RPG in a Box available if you would like to try it out for free. It has all of the functionality of the full version, but is limited to 2 maps. The maps are limited to 10x10, and there is a splash screen on exported games. The example game and assets used in this video are available in both versions, so regardless of the version you have, you'll be able to follow along. Every time you start RPG in a Box, you'll be greeted with the Game Manager window. The Game Manager is where you can create a new project or open an existing project to work on. The Game Manager contains options to create a new game, open an existing game, and exit the program. The Recent Games list contains a list of the projects that you've recently opened. Mousing over them will show their location on your hard drive. Double-clicking any of them will open them in RPG in a Box, as will having them highlighted, and then clicking Open. Clicking Remove will remove them from the Recent Games list, but will not delete the files from your hard drive. If you'd like to open a game that is not in the Recent list, you can click Open an Existing Game, navigate to the folder, open the game.cfg, which is the config file for the game, and it will open up. Then when you exit back to the Game Manager using this button, it will show up in the list. The Game Manager also has a handy link to the official Discord, where you can come say hi to Justin and I and all the awesome people that are there, and some neat little tips if you want to learn more about RPG in a Box. Now let's create a new game. I'm going to click Create a New Game, and now I'm going to give my game a title. I'm going to name it something that's unique and easily identifiable. Since it's for a tutorial, I'm calling it My Tutorial Game. Now let's pick where RPG in a Box will store the game's files. It defaults to your desktop, which I'm going to pick because I put everything there anyways. Now, if you'll notice, having this checkmark checked will cause RPG in a Box to make a subfolder with your game's title in the path that you've chosen. So if I uncheck this, it will just dump all my files right on the desktop. I don't want that, so I highly recommend leaving this box checked. And now this second checkbox will import the example content, which will give you a fully functioning example game with assets, maps, startup script, everything you need. So since this is a tutorial, we're doing that. Click OK, and here we go. So here we are in RPG in a Box. As you can see, the editor is broken up into several distinct areas. Up top, we have the main toolbar with options to export your game, test it out with quick play, a handy built-in sound effects generator, an option to open the built-in asset library, a window which will help you import external assets, the editor settings. Help will open up the documentation tab. The About will open up the About dialog. We already saw what Exit to Game Manager does, and Exit will close the program. Now we have the Game Explorer. The Game Explorer is essentially a file view of your game's components. The Game Explorer toolbar has several options. You can create a new resource, refresh the Game Explorer, which is handy when you add external files to your project folder from outside of RPG in a Box. Delete a resource, which will delete your resource off of your hard disk. Collapse all open folders, and you can select assets and favorite them. This will highlight them green, and then add them to your favorites menu, where you can reorder them or remove them. When the Link with Editor option is selected, opening an asset in an editor, here we have the Overworld map opened in the map editor, for example, will cause that asset to be selected in the Game Explorer. The Game Explorer is also how you access your game's configuration. The game configuration contains many options, and I'll be going over it in detail in a later video. As a brief overview, you can change your game title, your startup script, your player character, many options about your gameplay, including the mechanics, the camera. You can choose your cursors, add custom cursors, default sounds, edit the user interface, and much more. The Game Explorer also has two handy right-click menus. If you right-click on a folder, you can choose to create a new asset of that type, or open that folder's location on your hard drive. If you right-click on an asset, you can choose to rename it, duplicate it, add it to your favorites, open it on your hard drive, or delete it. You can also rename your game straight from the Game Explorer. Just click the title, type your new title, and hit enter. Underneath the Game Explorer are context-sensitive editor tools and properties tabs. These will change depending on the editor and asset you currently have open. The Voxel Editor is a fully featured voxel model creator, which will allow you to create your own custom assets and animate them using a frame-based animation system. The Map Editor is where it all comes together. This is where your assets combine to tell your story and create your game. The Script Editor uses an intuitive node-based system. You can also edit scripts directly using RPG in a Box's easy-to-learn scripting language, Boxite. The Dialogue Editor allows you to write dialogue for your NPCs in a visual flowchart style, with branching options due to player choices or conditions. The UI Editor allows you to create a custom UI theme for your game, create custom widgets, view your management screen, customize your main menu, and design your own credits. The Item Editor allows you to create items and edit their properties. You can set whether they can be used, be stacked, be equipped, be crafted, or even used as a tool. The Combat Editor is currently under construction, and as of version 0.6.4, it can be used to set up basic turn-based battles. The Stats Editor is also currently under construction. As of right now, you can set up leveling data and view default equipment slots. The documentation is a helpful repository of information about RPG in a Box. You can browse by topic, or even type in text for a search. On the far right are three helpful tabs containing all the 3D assets in your project: tiles, objects, and characters. You can filter by selecting from a list of tags. You can filter by typing in the tag, or you can filter by the name of the asset. Down at the bottom, there's a context-sensitive button, which will create a new asset of that type. And if your asset's favorited, you'll see a little gold star up in the corner. Right-clicking on any of the asset icons will bring up a menu, which will allow you to rename that asset, duplicate it, add it, or remove it from favorites, open the location of the asset on your hard disk, or delete it. If you'd like to access the documentation in a different way, try dragging Justin from up here in the corner onto something to bring up the corresponding documentation. When you import the example content, you'll essentially be importing a completely functional, albeit a very small and short, game. So exporting it to play or playing it using the quick play function will automatically work. However, if you're creating a completely new project Without importing the example assets, there are a few important elements that need to be set up in order to make your project playable. These are a map, a player character, and a startup script to load that map and place your player character in it. If we look at the game configuration of the example content, we can see that the startup script is called startup and that the player character is the Justin model. Let's open the startup script to see what it does. So navigate to scripts using the Game Explorer, then select startup. And as you can see, the startup script is very simple. It starts here, loads a map called Overworld, places the player at position 210, and makes the player character face south. Now let's open up the Overworld map using the map editor to see what it looks like. Map editor, Overworld. Now if we have the edit tools selected, mousing over a tile will display its coordinates in the lower right corner of the map editor. We can see this tile here where the paths intersect has a coordinate of 210, so that should be where Justin loads when the game is started. We can very easily check this by using the Quick Play function. Clicking Quick Play will automatically build and launch your game, so it is great for testing things out while you're working on your game. So if we click New Game, we can see that Justin is exactly where he's meant to be, and he's facing south. But what if you want to send your game to a friend, distribute it, or even sell it online? That's what the Export Game function is for. Click Export Game. Now select where you want to export your game to. I'm going to click Browse and then create a new folder on my desktop called Export Game. Select Current Folder. Next, I'll choose the target platform for my game. I'm using Windows, so I'm going to select Windows, but you can also export for Linux and Mac OS. Click OK, and in a few seconds, the folder that you exported your game to will pop up, containing two files, the .exe and the .pck file containing the data for your game. It's as simple as that. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for sticking around and for watching this tutorial. Hopefully I will get better as time goes on, but if you've enjoyed any part of it, if it's been helpful at all, then please give it a thumbs up and make my day. If you'd like to see more tutorials, then subscribe to the channel, click the notification bell, so you know when more are posted. If you'd like to support the development of RPG in a Box and the production of my tutorials, then visit the RPG in a Box Patreon where you can support me and Justin and see what we're up to. Thank you. Just a huge thank you from me and from Justin. If you want to purchase RPG in a Box, again, the links will be at the bottom. If you have any questions or comments, let me know. Look forward to seeing you soon. Thank you for sticking around. Bye-bye.